benefit of hanging around after a conference is to learn some different things. So the Global Speaker Summit just finished, and I'm here walking with Lee here. And you know what I discovered? I said, hey, you kind of look like a rapper. Let's see your shoes. And his jeans, he's like, you know, I was in a rap group. So tell us about that.
It was a long time ago in the 90s. Yeah. So I was in a group with two of my mates from school. And we traveled a bit, had a couple of songs and did some big events. We used to do a lot of youth events and stuff. And so I was a DJ and producer. Used to do lots of mixing and scratching and stuff. So
can you do a little scratching motion?
Yeah, I can do all that. But not with my mouth. I do it in the real. I still do the real thing. I still have turntables. You know, those big black CDs. That people don't get. So yeah, I still do it with vinyl and stuff occasionally. I've used it in some of my talks occasionally. So it's good fun.
So what's a couple of names of the songs? Do you remember?
Oh man, you probably wouldn't heard of them, but we did a song called Jumping, which was like a crowd song, and it was kind of like for young people, really. It was like we did a lot of youth events and kind of church events and things and that kind of thing. So it was a fun time. It was a fun time.
The white rappers from the UK doing like churchy type songs.
Yeah, it was interesting. Yeah, I did Manchester Arena, Sheffield Arena.
Whoa.
Did some big events over the years.
So how did you get such a big crowd? That's kind of a big deal.
I guess we just got into the right people, and we because when you're putting on an event, right, a rap group's really easy to organize because there's no drums, there's no microphone. You know, you just have two microphones and a DJ. We were quite easy to do, really. So I think people just thought, oh, we'll use those guys. So we had some fun. We did like Yorkshire rapping. So we used to rap in a northern accent because we didn't have that American style accent. So that was kind of our thing, you know. So
what was the name of your group?
It was called Hog. H-O-G, believe it or not. Thankfully, it's pre-YouTube. Thankfully, it's pre-kind of internet, really. So no one gets to see it, which is great for me.
Well, we'll be imagining. And Hog, does that stand out? Does that stand for something?
Yeah, you stand for House of God. That was the whole thing.
Oh.
H-O-G. But yeah, it's a long time ago. We have one famous song we did called Fig Rolls. And it was about our favourite biscuits. And so a couple of years ago, I was best man, so my mate, who was the rapper in the band, and so we put it as a ringtone on iTunes. So the only thing you can find is Figgy Rolls ringtone on iTunes, and we sold that at his wedding. So,
well, you know, Sir Mix-a-Lot sang about buttermilk biscuits. Here we go, roll the dough, do see no, 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 no. So, wow, you were onto something.
Yeah, but biscuits were important to us, and food generally was important to us. Yeah.
Right. So now we know why he kind of looks like a rapper. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's hilarious.